Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let's take a moment to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. We invoke your mercy in humble prayer, O Lord, that you may cause us, your servants, corrected by penance and schooled by good works, to persevere sincerely in your commands, and come safely to the Paschal festivities through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once to your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, for they have become depraved. They have soon turned aside from the way I pointed out to them, making for themselves a molten calf and worshiping it, sacrificing to it, and crying out, 'This is your God, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I see how stiff-necked this people is. Let me alone then, that my wrath may blaze up against them to consume them. Then I will make of you a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord, his God, saying, "Why, O Lord, should your wrath blaze up against your own people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, with such great power and with so strong a hand? Why should the Egyptians say, 'With evil intent he brought them out, that he might kill them in the mountains and exterminate them from the face of the earth'? Let your blazing wrath die down. Relent in punishing your people. Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and how you swore to them by your own self, saying, 'I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and all this land that I promised, I will give your descendants as their perpetual heritage.'" So the Lord relented in the punishment he had threatened to inflict on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As you favor your people.
Jesus said to the Jews, "If I testify on my own behalf, my testimony is not true. But there is another who testifies on my behalf, and I know that the testimony that he gives on my behalf is true. He sent emissaries to John, and he testified to the truth. I do not accept human testimony, but I say this so that you may be saved. He was a burning and shining lamp, and for a while you were content to rejoice in his light. But I have testimony greater than John's. The works that the Father gave me to accomplish, these works that I perform testify on my behalf that the Father has sent me. Moreover, the Father who sent me has testified on my behalf. But you have never heard his voice nor seen his form. And you do not have his word remaining in you because you do not believe in the one whom he has sent. You search the scriptures because you think that you have eternal life through them. Even they testify on my behalf. But you do not want to come to me to have life. I do not accept human praise. Moreover, I know that you do not have the love of God in you. I came in the name of the Father, but you do not accept me. Yet if another comes in his own name, you will accept him. How can you believe when you accept praise from one another and do not seek the praise that comes from the only God? Do you not think that I will accuse you before the Father? The one who will accuse you before the Father is Moses, in whom you have placed your hope. For if you had believed Moses, you would have believed me, because he wrote about me. But if you do not believe in writings, how will you believe in my words?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have a fun gospel today. Kind of long, kind of convoluted at times, but yet it's talking about human testimony. John the Baptist testifying on Jesus' behalf. He says, "The greater testimony than that which God's." Different times that the Father speaks, saying, "This is my beloved Son," of the Gospels. He says, "Even greater testimony." And he's like, "I'm not going to continue. Moses will." It's fascinating to think of Moses because of the Jews' pinnacle of goodness is Moses. And it's fun to pair that with our first reading, which is a classic example of that in the Old Testament, why modern readers sometimes struggle with the Old Testament. And they say, "You know, God of the Old Testament seems a little different. It's talking about burning and killing Israel every now and then. What's that about?" And so in the context of what's going on in the Old Testament, it's very important to think about what's going on. Moses is beginning his journey with these Israelites in the desert. And it's at the very beginning of this journey that he pulls Moses aside and says, "Hey, bud, these people, kind of crazy, don't you think?" He's like, "Yeah, they are pretty crazy, aren't they? Hey, Moses, I should probably kill them, shouldn't I? They don't follow me very well. You know God. We should not kill them." And here's why. Because even though they turn away from you from time to time, they're still good people. And it's interesting to see, what is the purpose of this dialogue? "Hey, Moses, you're about to be stuck with these people for 40 years. They're going to drive you crazy, and you're going to want to call down fire and brimstone upon them. Don't do that." Moses, what is Moses' job the whole time in the desert? His job is to pray for the people each and every time they turn away from the Father. His job is to cry out to God unendingly, day and night. "Heavenly Father, these people need your help. Help them out, please." Over and over and over again, "Please help them out." It's interesting that before he's stuck with them for 40 years in the desert with nothing else around them to distract them, they have this little exchange where God says, "Hey, Moses, what do you think about this?" And he's trying to get Moses to understand his role. It's beautiful to see this because sometimes whenever we're stuck with people in tight spaces for a certain period of time,
maybe that's your case today, you start to realize some things about people that are imperfect, as Moses saw with his brothers and sisters, the Israelites. And sometimes we're called to ignore those things, but I think more often than not, whenever we see an imperfection in a brother and sister, or someone who's driving us crazy at times, the purpose of that is so we can pray for that. So we can pray for them. The Lord knows that just as we let you to pray for them, it's good for us, it's good for them as well. And the Lord knows we ourselves are not perfect and probably drive other people crazy as well. During this time of social distancing, I'm sure that there are some people who were not distanced from, who were maybe drive crazy a time or two. Let's continue to remember that we're called to pray for them. We're called to go into the desert so we can see these things. And part of the whole purpose of going into the desert for the Israelites is so that whenever you eliminate all the distractions, you hear the voice of the Father more clearly. Moses, he doesn't hear this conversation amidst the people. He's called to go up into the mountain and have this conversation with God when all the other distractions are put away. Because if Moses had this conversation right after they did something crazy, I'm sure his conversation may have done a little differently with God. Today, let us remember the Father continues to draw us closer to Him. Let us remember He desires to speak words of love and mercy to our hearts. Let's open up our hearts to hear these words and to spend some time during these days listening to the Heavenly Father. The Word came among us that we may hear Him more clearly. Now let us stand and lift up our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. We pray for Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all those who lead and guide the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all leaders of nations and countries, that they may be good stewards of their worldly power and authority, providing and caring for the needs of the poor and the vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the sick and the suffering, for the isolated, the incarcerated, the homeless, the homebound, and those who mourn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the faithful departed, especially those who will die this day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and loving Father, we know you hear and answer all of our prayers and petitions, those we have voiced and those we hold in the silence of our hearts. We entrust them all into your loving care through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth through our human hands. Come for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the divine work of human hands. Come for us, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be accepted to the Lord God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we offer in sacrifice may cleanse us in our frailty from every evil, and grant always us your protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them in the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one. Holy Spirit, remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we may be blessed with Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, who may merit to be co-heirs to our life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven, Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
and take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I will place my law within them, and I will write it upon their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people, says the Lord. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received purify us, we pray, O Lord, and grant your servants freedom from all blame, that those bound by a guilty conscience may glory in the fullness of heavenly remedy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now in the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down with the blessing. O God, protector of all who hope in you, bless your people, keep them safe, defend them, prepare them, that free from sin and safe from the enemy, they may persevere always in your love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.